Hello friends, welcome to UPSC Logics and my name is Siddharth and today I'm going to discuss the Godavari Mega Aqua Park. So this is the first Mega Aqua Park that has been commissioned and the Union Minister Srimati Harsimrat Kaur Badal, who had laid foundation with Mr. Chandrababu Naidu on 17th November 2015 when she was the Minister for Food Processing, has commissioned the Godavari Mega Aqua Park at Tundurru Village in Bhimavaram Mandal, West Godavari District, Andhra Pradesh. So to give a major boost to the food processing sector by adding value and reducing food wastage at each stage of the supply chain and with particular focus on perishables, the Ministry of Food Processing Industries had implemented the Mega Food Park scheme in the country. The Mega Food Parks create a modern infrastructure facility for food processing along with value chain from farm to market with strong forward and backward linkages through a cluster-based approach. And the common facilities that are available with enabling infrastructure are created at the central processing centers, and facilities for primary processing and storage is created near the farm in the form of primary processing centers and collection centers. So under the scheme, the Government of India provides financial assistance up to Rs. 50 crore per mega food park project. So this particular food park, which is under the Godavari Mega Aqua Food Park Private Limited, has been set up in 57.81 acres of land and has costed around Rs. 122.60 crores. So the facilities that have been created, and this is under the Ananda Group, and the facilities that have been created at the central processing center of this mega food park include pre-processing line for fish of 1.5 ton per hour, pre-processing line for shrimp of 1.5 ton per hour, freezing of fish at 1.5 tons per hour, and freezing of shrimp at 1.5 tons per hour. And then there is a cold storage facility as well for the fish, which stands at 2000 metric ton. So cold storage for shrimp is at 1000 metric ton. Then there is an ice plant, food testing laboratories, besides other state of the art enabling infrastructure. So this modern infrastructure for food processing that has been created at the park will benefit the farmers, growers, processors, consumers of Andhra Pradesh and adjoining areas, and will provide a big boost for the growth of food processing sector in the state of Andhra Pradesh. So let us have a look at how this particular thing works. So the Godavari Mega Aqua Food Park Private Limited's core processing center is at Tundurru Village in Bhimavaram region, and this acts as a hub. And this comprises of two primary processing centers, which are at Amalapuram in East Godavari District and Karlapalem in Guntur District. This, along with 9 collection centers, one each in the 9 coastal districts of the state of Andhra Pradesh. So what is happening that the trawlers come in and the fish is then collected and sent to the core processing center in Bhimavaram. So the Mega Food Park is developed in 57.81 acres of land, and it offers pre-processing, processing, packaging, storage, along with transportation facilities, providing a world-class infrastructure and technology to the enterprises, both farmers and processors that are engaged in the aqua food processing industry. The Godavari Mega Aqua Food Park will provide a platform and establish the backward and forward linkages covering the entire aqua food processing value chain, giving a quality assurance and food safety and implementation of best practices in the post-harvest management. So let us have a look at the mission of the Godavari Mega Aqua Food Park Private Limited, and it is to operate a state-of-the-art aqua food processing facility dedicated to producing environmentally sustainable premium fish, shrimp and associated aqua products for the domestic and world markets. The focus is on quality and consistency, and Godavari Mega Aqua Food Park Private Limited brings reliability and sustainability to aqua farmers. The vision of the same is to strive to make our environmental carbon footprint as small as possible, and they shall utilize alternative sources of energy such as wind, solar, and hydro to reduce the dependence on traditional power. When it comes to perishables, the location of the core processing center is of the utmost importance. So the site has excellent road connectivity and is connected with the National Highway 214, which is also known as the Coastal Corridor, through a 2-kilometer all-weather road. The location is strategically advantageous as it is in the middle of a major aquaculture zone of Andhra Pradesh, and that is also considered as a national hub for aquaculture in India. So the strategic positioning of the geographical center of India, the Aqua Food Park is almost equidistant from key consumption markets and ports on the south coast. So if you have a look at this picture, it is just 10 kilometers away from the state highway SH7, then it is just 2 kilometers away from the national highway NH214, 110 kilometers away from the Kakinada port on the south coast, and 12 kilometers away from the Narsapur railway station. So let us have a look at the core infrastructure which this facility has to offer. And number one is the pre-processing facilities for fish. This is washing and grading, then deheading them, gutting them, weighing them, and packing them. Similar facilities are available for the shrimp as well, which is washing and grading, deheading, weighing, and packing them. The freezing facilities for fish are IQF, which is individual quick freezers, and plate freezers. The same facilities are for freezing for shrimp as well, which is again the IQF, individual quick freezers, and the plate freezers. Then there is a block ice plant and a microbial testing laboratory available, which does a water analysis, microbial analysis, and antibiotic testing. Then the processing facilities for fish are de-skinning, filleting, grading machine, flake ice, and soaking machines. The processing facilities for shrimp that are available are shrimp peeling, deveining, grading, soaking, and flake ice machines. The cold storage for fish are racking with pellets, and the same goes for the cold storage of shrimps as well, which is racking with pellets. Then there are reefer trucks, insulated trucks, and trailers for raw and finished goods, and automated fish shrimp harvesting machines, which is brought from Aqualife USA. So the park just doesn't have the processing facilities. It also has an enabling infrastructure, which is a water reservoir with an overhead tank of 300,000 liters. Then there is an intake water treatment system, or the WTP. There is a central effluent treatment system, or the ETP. There is involvement of aquaponics system. Then there is a central power distribution system of 5 megawatts. Then there are diesel generators for power backup. There is a weighbridge of 60 metric ton. There is a parking area, and there are roads with street lights. So let us have a look at the fish varieties that are being processed in this particular plant. Number one is tilapia and whole fish, and fresh and chilled, head and gutted, headless gutted, fish fillets, curry cuts, and steaks would be available. Then there is pangasius, and again whole fish, fresh and chilled, head-on gutted, headless gutted, fish fillets, curry cuts, steaks would be available. Similarly, rohu and katla would be available. And besides this, lot of varieties of finished products that are ready to fry and eat would be available, like burgers, cutlets, samosas, etc. So let us now have a look at the shrimp varieties. And number one is the vanamai, or the white shrimp. So again, this will be available in head-on, headless, easy peel, PD tail-on, PD tail-off, butterfly, breaded, skewers, etc. Then there is black tiger. Again, this will be available in the similar fashion as white shrimps. Then sea cod tiger and scampi would be available as well. And besides this, finished products which are ready to fry and eat would be available with the shrimp varieties as well. So this brings us to the end of this video, and I hope you have enjoyed this video. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon if you have liked this video and you love prawns. So thank you so much for watching, and Jai Hind.